Summer's here and the sun is shining bright, and you know what that means. It's time to break out the hater blockers.
I love that.
Yeah.
Here to show off the hottest sunglass styles for summer is celebrity eyewear consultant Eden Wexler. Welcome
Hi.
To the show.
Hi, Eden. It's so good to see you. It's been ages.
I know, it has.
You still look fabulous, girl.
Thank you.
Okay. So let's talk about your title, because I love it. You are a shade consultant.
Sure. I mean, it's not my official title as far as my company is concerned, but I get called that a lot in the media just because over the years, it's been 16 years now that I've been with Safilo and with Solstice Sunglasses, that I've outfit over 10,000 celebrities. So I guess that gives me that title in the media.
Well, how do you find the perfect shade for the perfect face? Because your clients include, what, Robert Downey Jr.?
I have to say, I'm very lucky when it comes to fitting celebrities because they're usually so beautiful
That's
and
true.
Have the fabulous features for on camera, you know, both of you, for example, same thing, that it's easy, you know. So where it gets a little bit more difficult if you're like the every person where everyone, you know, they complain that they have issues, that they don't like certain features on their face, so they don't think glasses look good on them. So that's the complaint that I get most from common people.
Right,
do celebrities like over-the-top sunglasses? Do they tend to veer towards something that's just going to be conspicuous?
You know, they used to. It just depends on the times. You know, when I first started doing this, you know, that was the trend, very oversized, very ostentatious, lots of crystals, lots of bling, you know, lots of big logos.
Yeah.
But, you know, the times have changed, and so the celebrities go with those times.
Gotcha.
So, you know, you have your few celebrities, like, you know, a Rihanna, let's say, for example, who still will wear something over the top, and she can rock it, and then, you know, people follow her in what she's wearing, so.
Okay, but now it's more geared towards
understatement. For the most part, it's a little bit more subtle. You'll see, for the most part, the shades have sized down, you know, they're much more easy to wear, so that's nice for most of us.
Now, what about for kids? Sun protection for kids. Are you finding more and more kids are using sunglasses to protect their
parents
eyes?
Parents are, you know, starting to get the wake-up call.
Uh-huh.
I love to be able to talk about that here because it is really important. You know, certainly sunglasses look adorable when you see them on a little child.
Yes.
And so they appear to be just a fashion accessory, but they truly are important for a child's eyes because did you know that they get 3 times more UV radiation than an adult does?
Wow.
Yeah, their pupils are larger,
you
more sun is coming
now.
In the eyes, so I know you have a little one.
Yeah.
And so it's really, really important that they wear sunglasses and polarized lenses in particular are great because they really reflect the rays, and so it's more comfortable on the eyes for children.
And you brought some little ones here for us.
It's yes.
in the corner over there.
Yeah, so I know this is a sunglass segment, but I just wanted to share this collection with you, which is Kids by Safilo.
Okay.
It's a new optical collection that's coming out specifically targeted to 0 to 8-year-olds.
Oh.
Yes, and so 1 in 6 children globally have a vision problem. Who knew, right?
Yeah.
But did you also know that first of all, you have to make sure by 6 months of age, because your little one's
going
to be 5 months, at 6 months you need to take them for their first eye exam.
Okay, good to
if
know.
If their eyes are not corrected by the age of 8, whatever they saw, however they see, at age 8 will be how they see for the rest of their life. So
oh,
if
no.
they see blurry, it will be blurry forever. So it's really important. So that's why I just wanted to focus on this collection, because this is an important message.
I have to
message.
Ask a dumb non-parent question.
Sure.
How's a kid going to do a reading test at 6 months? I'm sure there's something
well,
else.
Well, this is why you have specialists, pediatric ophthalmologists and opticians who focus on this, you know, optometrists.
Wow. I like this.
Yes.
F-G-Y.
I've been wondering that myself, but, you know, they've got their ways. They figure that out.
So let's turn a page to the trends.
Yes, yes. So then moving on to kids' sunglasses, because as I said, it's very, very important that you protect the child's eyes.
Mm-hmm.
We have great styles for kids. These are from Polaroid with polarized lenses, the first two.
Nice.
The next two are from Carrera.
Ooh,
so
Carrera.
Super cute. Basically, it's, you know, toned down styles that look like, you know, they're adult styles that have been sized down for children.
With great
so super
colors.
Cute, no metal hinges, so they're safe,
perfect.
They're comfortable. And, you know, Polaroid, for example, $39. So it's so
reasonable.
Affordable. You know,
good
you
price.
Can afford to be able to lose a pair or two.
You can buy all colors
yes.
for the little bird.
Yes. Yes, and Polaroid is actually the inventor of the polarized lens. I don't know if you knew that. They
I
came out
that.
With the lens 10 years before the camera. In this country, we only know about the camera.
That's right.
But
really?
If you go to Europe. It is the second largest collection in all of Europe for sunglasses.
Ooh,
and like, so David Beckham and, you know, other celebrities who live, you know, abroad, when they come here, they, you know, we've had David literally come into our Soho Solstice sunglasses store and pick out Polaroids. So,
David Beckham.
So he knows.
I know,
lens.
Right?
Yes.
This, what is this section bringing?
So moving on to adults. So we have
aviators.
Some. Yes, these are updated aviators. Carrera, which has always been such a hot brand in sunglasses. This is, do you want to try them on?
This is moving me right now.
Oh, this one? This is a pair of Kate Spade. They have leather temples on the side. They're a little small for you, I would say, Patrick.
A little small for you.
Right.
Get Patrick
but
a pair
the
that'll
Carrera
work for him.
Glasses have actually been remastered. These were iconic styles from like the 1970s that have been sized down and shaped to be more wearable and comfortable.
Okay.
A pair here below is from Tommy Hilfiger, and then we have another pair here from Juicy Couture.
Okay.
So our next.
So you can move on, and I'm going to try these.
Yes, sure. Please do.
I think this may be better.
See, much better.
Better.
These look amazing on you.
Yeah, I take notes.
Yeah, the
I woke
Carrera
up like
champion.
Yes. I like those.
They're amazing on you.
Thank you.
Wonderful. So the next trend is mirrored lenses.
Oh,
so,
that's a big trend.
Yeah, it's a really big trend. A lot of celebrities are wearing the mirrored lenses. And in particular, I've outlined all these right here on here as blue ones because I'm seeing blue as the biggest color. Right here, this third pair down is actually from Bobbi Brown. I don't know if you know the cosmetics maven. Bobbi Brown came out with a sunglass collection. And so this is from her Lifeguard collection, which is all about sandy nudes and blues.
Beautiful.
So that's why I've showcased the blue collection. But on the table here, you can see the entire range of the Polaroid Rainbow collection. So I thought these would look amazing for you to try on because they go with your tangerine color.
Absolutely do.
What do you think?
Oh, this is
I mean, for $60, a polarized lens, you can't beat it.
Yes,
these look
so cute. Internet diva. Diva, can you give us a little strut? Can you just do a little strut? Yes. And what?
Okay, moving right along.
Now these are round.
So yes, so round is another big trend. Probably the Olsen sisters can be credited for that trend. They started it quite a few years ago. It took the rest of the world to really catch up with that trend. And now everybody is rocking round glasses.
Very John Lennon-esque.
Yes,
very
Janis Joplin. Exactly. So this pair is so interesting because again, this is from Carrera. And if you've noticed down here, I've got all of these interchangeable fronts. So when you buy these, they actually have a snap-on front.
So you're
really getting two glasses for the price of one. So this is very,
very
innovative.
Cool. I love that.
You know, Mad Men has been such, you know, a big TV show, inspired a lot of vintage looking trends, retro trends. So we have a pair from Banana Republic, Hugo Boss, and Kate Spade.
Now cat eye, is that?
Yes, that's the next trend here. We have cat eyes. So
they've been in
for quite a while. As you can see, this is just a little bit more modernized. This one, again, is from Bobbi Brown. We have a Kate Spade. Smith is an interesting brand. It's actually one of her proprietary brands are celebrating their 50th anniversary this year. I don't know if you are a skier, but you know they're known for their snow goggles. They're really big in North America for snow goggles. They've come out with sunglasses and eyeglasses, and so this is a great retro pair from
them. This pair on.
I love the color combo with that pair. In fact,
I'll try these on, and let's go to the next set.
And then what's over here?
So our last trend is, let's see, how do
those
look?
Too cute.
Yes.
Too cute.
I love.
Okay.
Very cute.
Next set.
So our last trend is retro. So retro inspiration. So this first pair, you know, is Wayfarer-esque. This is from Carrera, and they actually have linen inside them.
Oh, that is nice.
It's a new textile innovation that, you know, we have. It's, you know, proprietary
Very
to us.
Very intricate.
So there's linen in there. This next pair, the blue pair, is a pair from Bobbi Brown, and Naomi Watts just wore them at the Cannes Film Festival.
You're kidding.
And then what else do I have?
Flats or high heels? That's the question.
I don't remember. I only was paying attention to her sunglasses.
That's the only accessory that matters at Cannes.
Our next pair is from Jack Spade. I don't know if you're familiar with that brand. It's kind of like the cousin to Kate Spade.
That's right.
And then the bottom pair is from Fossil. So all very retro, cool styles that are very in again.
I'm going to try these. These might be too small.
So let's see.
Eden, how do we go about finding the right sunglasses for our face?
They're nice, she says.
They're very nice.
There you go. Well, how do we go about finding
the right sunglasses? Well, the one thing you want to do is pay attention to your face shape. You want to generally go with something that is opposite of your face shape. So if you're super round, you don't want to wear a pair of like super round glasses. So you want to do the opposite. So you want to go with something more rectangular, something with more angle.
So it's complementing more than matching.
But by doing the opposite.
Gotcha.
So that might sound a little
strange.
But that's the great, you know, just rule of thumb, just to try on something and see if it's kind of opposite of what your face shape is doing to, balance you out. My next recommendation truly would be to go into, you know, like a Solstice sunglasses store or another store where they have experts who are trained in this who can really help you based on your face shape. Because it is a little confusing, and it's hard to know what fits right. One thing I like to do, I perfected this with Deborah Messing on the set of Will and Grace several years ago, is the smile test.
Okay.
So if you smile, let's see what happens. Okay, these work, but they do, they're pinching your cheeks a little bit when you smile, so it's not like the best thing.
They're not perfect.
Try my cheekbones, my cheekbones.
Perfect, these are perfect. Because what happens sometimes, if the glasses really don't fit well, they will literally go like this.
Oh.
I was having lunch with one of my girlfriends once, and they were not a pair of our glasses, nor did I fit her in them. And we're sitting there, and she started laughing about something we're talking about. I'm like, oh my God, those glasses are awful. You have to take them off.
They were moving.
Although, I mean, you know, I guess you don't realize this.
Yeah.
You know, so make sure you have an expert. Take a look at you.
Okay.
You know, you can always bring them back if you, you know, didn't like
what
you
bought. Can we just take you? I think we should just bring you.
And you know, but a big thing I would really recommend is don't buy your sunglasses from a street vendor. You don't want to buy them from a vintage shop because you want to make sure that they truly have the UVA, UVB, UVC protection.
Oh, right.
And if you're buying them from, let's say, a vintage shop, I mean, you have no idea. I mean, these glasses are sitting around 30, 40 years. I can't imagine that the UV protection is operable.
Okay.
So
this is great.
Really, really important to do that. Make sure you go to a reputable retailer, find a reputable brand.
Ian Wexler, you're the best.
Oh, you're welcome.
Fantastic.
The best.
Aren't these great?
I think we're
fabulous.
You look amazing.
You bet they're so fabulous.
You're watching Arise Entertainment 360. We'll be right back.